Hi guys, I am AJ from ClearTax. In today's video, we will learn about turnover based audit under GST, and this is also known as GSTR 9C. There are three types of audits under GST, and turnover based audit under section 35(5) is one of them. Applicability of section 35(5). If the aggregate turnover of a registered person exceeds 2 crores in a financial year, he has to get his accounts audited by chartered accountant or a cost accountant. However, filing of GSTR 9C for the financial year 18-19 has been waived off for the businesses having aggregate turnover of less than 5 crores. How will the turnover be calculated? The aggregate turnover of a PAN will be sum of the following items. Number 1. Value of all taxable supplies, both interstate and intrastate. Number 2. Exempt supplies. Number 3. Export supplies of all goods and services. Who can perform the GST audit? Only a chartered accountant or a cost accountant is allowed to perform GST audit under section 35 of CGST Act. It is to be noted that an internal auditor cannot parallelly be appointed as GST auditor. Also, the GST Act does not allow GST practitioners to perform GST audit. Appointment of GST auditor. A proprietor, partner or board of directors in case of a company should appoint GST auditor at the beginning of the financial year. Accounts to be reviewed by GST auditor. The following are the accounts and records that should be reviewed by the auditor. Number 1. Sales register. Number 2. Purchase register. Number 3. Stock register. Number 4. Expense ledger. Number 5. Input tax credit availed and utilized. Number 6. Output tax paid and payable. Number 7. E-way bills raised during the audit period. Number 8. Any communication from GST department related to that year. Submission of GST audit report. The auditor has to complete the audit and prepare reconciliation statement as per GSTR 9C format. The GSTR 9C can be certified by same CA who conducted the GST audit, or any other CA can also certify it. The following must be reported and certified by the GST auditor or certifier. Number 1. Whether or not all the requisite accounts and records are maintained. Number 2. Whether or not financial statements have been prepared as per books of account. Number 3. Certifying accuracy of information in GSTR 9C. Number 4. To list down the audit observations or reservations or comments, if any. The auditor must report any tax liability pending for payment identified during the audit. Taxpayers can settle the taxes as recommended by auditor in form DRC-03. Due date for submission of GST audit report. The GSTR 9C is due on or before 31st December of subsequent financial year. However, the due date to file GSTR 9C for the financial year 18-19 has been extended till 30th September 2020. Penalty for non-submission of GST audit report. There is no specific provision for GSTR 9C default. Hence, it is subject to a general penalty of 25,000. For more information on this topic, please click on the link provided in the description of this video. If you like the video, please do like and share. Also, do subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. And don't forget to hit on the bell icon so that you will never miss an update from ClearTax. Stay tuned for more updates. Thank you.